Hey guys, welcome back to the channel, welcome back to the studio. Remember, give a thumbs up to these videos, leave a comment below and subscribe to the channel. And you can always freely share this content with family, friends on your social media, email or whoever you think that can benefit from this. Now, I'm not gonna say his name. I'm gonna let him say his name. Hey, what's your name? Who you are, and you know where you're from?
All right. So like, I have a funny name. My name is Homelo. So that's basically like a fruit name. Mm-hmm. Just change the first letter to H. Mm-hmm. So that's Homelo. And you can call me Mel. People in the Philippines, perhaps, calls me Mel. So yeah.
Oh, nice. So Mel is from the Philippines, and Mel, what's your like background? Where are you from, and you know, what do you do?
So yeah, so like I'm from Central Philippines. I'm from Iloilo. I'm a nurse, and I used to be a missionary nurse with Philippine Adventist Medical Aviation Services.
Oh, nice. So how did you get into Philippines Adventist Medical Aviation Services?
Yes, that's actually an interesting story to tell. So I have a friend who works as a missionary pilot at the Philippine Adventist Medical Aviation Services, and he was initially based in Northern Philippines in Banwar. So I told him that after my examination, I will be visiting him for a couple of weeks, and he agreed to that. But as time goes by, a week before completing my examination, he informed me that he was transferred to the Palawan base, and I told him, sure, I'm still gonna visit you anyway. So I visited the Palawan base, and I met people who are also working as missionaries in the base, and that's how I got into PAMAS. Mm. So like I was telling, the initial plan is just to visit that friend, but I was surprised that God has actually led me to be in PAMAS. Why? Because the director asked me if I could stay and volunteer as a missionary nurse in the work. So at that time, since it was not my plan, there's only one answer in my mind, and that was a yes.
So you were basically ambushed. You visited, next thing you know, there was vacancy for a missionary nurse, and they invited you. You said yes. What was your experience like?
Okay, so that my experience in PAMAS was, I should say, life changing. Because as a nurse, I thought at first I will only deal with the nursing care of my patients and just do the medical stuff. But I was wrong, because working with PAMAS as a missionary nurse does not only confine you to the nursing job, but do also a lot of things like we visit community, we do health expo, we visit the sick, we go to the mission schools, we do Bible study also to the community, we join the crusades, help out in the crusades, we also do constructions. And when I say doing construction, like when we were trying to build up a shop, we also help in the harvest of the rice in the rice field, and so many things that you will find in the work in the field.
Oh, awesome. Okay, now I'm sure you've had a lot of experiences in doing those things. What are the experiences that you've had where you saw God's leading in that in the outcome?
Okay, so like working as a missionary nurse in PAMAS is actually, I should say, you'll never know what the day has to offer. So one time we were actually at the mountain. It's like an hour hike to the mountain, and I was tasked to do a special song for the divine service. But then all of a sudden we receive a call, and oh, there's like a patient that needs to be transported or evacuated from an island called Culion. Yes. I was not able to sing in the divine service, but instead we flew directly to the island in Culion to get that patient. And while we were flying to that island, there's like a crosswind, okay, and I felt like the plane that we're boarding is like just a paper because of the crosswind. And so I was thinking, oh, am I gonna die right now? So I was discussing with our pilot, and I was saying, oh, I felt like our plane is just like paper. And so our director said, like, yeah, maybe we should say a prayer. Now is the perfect timing for us to say a prayer. So when our director said that we should pray, it scared me more, because it's like, oh, if the director was inviting me for a prayer, things must be very scary right now. And then we prayed, and then like, thankfully we were able to land safely.
Yeah.
So that's just one of the experiences that I've had, which I could say life changing.
So basically you prayed and the wind sort of calmed down a bit, you landed safely. And
that's
like,
correct.
Thank you, Lord.
Yes.
Awesome. say on a regular medevac flight and so on, what was like your duties like when you accompanied the pilot and so on? What would you do as a missionary nurse?
Yes, so it actually starts in a call or a message that will be sent to our base. And we will go to that patient, we will be picking up the patient to where he's coming from. So when we arrive in that place, I will be assessing the patient, we'll be checking the vital signs, the condition of the patient, of course, and we'll be doing some documentation, okay? And after which, we'll be flying the patient to the hospital of choice, okay? And we will be doing endorsement, we give pertinent information to the medical team who will be receiving the patient.
Okay.
And also we do monitor the patient while we are in flight.
You mentioned that outside of flying along with the flights, picking up patients, you were actively helping out outside of that with like gardening, harvesting rice, construction, and so on. How did missionary work affect your spiritual life? Did that help you to grow, or how did it affect your spiritual life?
It actually helped me a lot, because I'm the type of person who is very impatient and very straightforward when I don't like things. I confront it right away. I'm sarcastic. Okay. So working with different kinds of people with different culture, because we're not all Filipinos there, and you deal with your patients as well, Christians, Muslims, and some Palawano tribes, there's definitely a cultural differences. So I've learned how to adjust, okay? And I've learned to say a prayer when things get rough, like say I get so angry with things. The word always reminds me that I need to embody a Christ-like character, I need to be patient, I need to win people with love, even if they're rude to me or rude to us, because we are there to be God's ambassador, and we should portray a Christ-like character.
Oh, very, very, very awesome. So, subscribers, some of them are nurses, some of them are, you know, just maybe young people thinking about joining missionary work and whether they're gonna be a part of PAMES or they're gonna go somewhere else. What would you say to those who are watching who might be contemplating doing missionary work, whether they're gonna be a missionary nurse or just a missionary in general? What would you recommend for them to start?
Yes, so I believe personally that as a medical missionary, this job is an effective instrument for us to win souls for Christ and to win the hearts of the people. We can do a lot of things, or as a medical missionary, you can do a lot of things. You can visit the sick people who just do not need the physical healing, but also spiritual healing. It is an avenue for us to pray for the sick, to minister for the sick, and to share God's love for those who need to hear it. So I invite everyone who are very much willing to become a medical missionary, whether it be full-time, part-time. I'm sure if the Lord will call, we should respond, and the Lord has prepared a way for us to do His work here on earth.
Oh, awesome. So one thing I like with Mel, as he mentioned, you know, it was just visiting a friend already doing it, and he had skills that he had learned in the past with, you know, nursing especially, and he just got plugged into the ministry. And praise the Lord, you were a flexible person where they could, you know, when you're not doing your nursing stuff, they could give you a shovel and get you doing some dirty work and stuff, and I'm sure he enjoyed that. As a missionary, so to speak, were you like somewhat compensated financially to say, okay, that became a motivation for you, where at the end of the day you're stressed, you're tired, but you have a salary that you got, so you know you kept going. How did you survive financially with your needs and so on doing missionary work?
Yes, God has provided all of my needs when I was there at the field. While it may be difficult for one who has no financial support to survive, but the Lord has a thousand ways, of course, to provide for His ministers, His workers, to continue the job that He has given us. So while I was in Pamas, I actually received a stipend, but I can say that you don't really need to have a stipend to survive while you're in the mission field, because you only need trust. Okay, when you trust that the Lord will provide for you, will sustain you, you will for sure survive. Okay, so I cling on to that Bible promise, which says that for God shall supply all my needs according to His riches in His glory. So that's a living testimony which I was able to personally experience when I was in the field.
Oh, that's awesome. So where are you now and what are you doing? Are you still doing missionary work under Pamas, or you ventured out elsewhere?
So right now, thankfully, I was able to pass the bar exam.
Yay!
And I'm connected now with De La Cruz and Caballo Law Office. We still help the church, like we help them in the legal issues. And I still continue to help in every way I can, with whatever I can contribute in the mission field. So if the field would need some legal stuff to do, I can contribute in that as well.
Oh, very good. So basically you do law as well. You're a lawyer of some sort?
Yes, right now. I'm practicing law at the same time I'm teaching also in a nursing school.
Wow, man with many hats. Right. Do you want anyone to keep in touch with you, your progress? You have social media, Instagram, or your Facebook might be more private, but do you want anyone to follow your progress of what you're doing in ministry and so on?
Yeah, so they can visit my Instagram page. It's hbs.com.
All right, we'll put it on the screen so they'll see it and they can connect with you. Well, you've heard it, guys. Mel finished nursing, visited a friend. Next thing you know, he's a missionary nurse. And I've seen a lot of his videos and posts and his experience. And even at one point, he was getting a little crash course on how to fly airplane and helicopter. What was that experience like for you?
So I didn't really expect that will be a consolation prize for me, I should say. So when I was at the base, I earned more or less 180 flying hours.
Wow.
Yeah. With the fixed wing and the helicopter.
Wow. So if the Lord was to lead you down to learn how to fly helicopter or airplane, you've had enough hours to go way past the student who've never flown these things before.
I know, yeah.
So are you praying about it by any chance, or?
Well, I'm always open, because I believe that when the Lord calls you, you can never say no.
Awesome. Well, we want to really praise the Lord for Mel, his service, and your time. I'm sure a lot of people here in the Philippines have been blessed by your ministry and the different things that you have accomplished and so on. We'll hear more from Mel at some point on our studio. We'll see him again. I'll definitely invite him back to share more of his experience. Thanks, Mel, for coming.
Sure.
And may God bless you in your missionary efforts. Thank you again for everything you've done, and God bless. Talk to you guys soon.